Okay, we're now going into a
glacier. This year's orbit is a pulse. A pulse is higher than the normal rate of advancement. 3D.
Okay, there it is.
Certain amount of snow and ice are deposited in the winter, and in the summer a certain amount of snow and ice is melted or spent. When the budget is unbalanced, with more deposited than spent, the glacier surges forward. When more is spent than accumulated, the glacier retreats. Surges do not normally last longer than a year, but there's just no way of predicting just when the balance is tipped to one status or the other.
Come on, that's awesome. Still getting closer and closer.
The particles called rock flour are so fine, they stay suspended in the water for a long time and give it a milky appearance. In a short term, these particles alter the color of the water.
We're now cutting through the ice. Closer and closer, and there we are. Maybe a quarter of a mile to go. Maybe we're going to have a picnic on the glacier. Closer, closer, closer. Ooh. You'll hear the boat cutting through the ice.
I don't think it's enough.
Closer. since I last reported to you. And we ain't going backwards. We're still going forward.
Now, how do you like that? Is that an unbelievable sight?
Yards in the face of the glacier and still going forward. Look at that, gang, the part of the ice is falling into the sea. Ice going into the water. Turner. so we're going to say goodbye to our glacier. Can't stay here very long. I can't get my camera wet. This is the Columbia Glacier. That's something. Starting to leave the glacier now. Sit in the back of the boat. As they say, you've seen one glacier, you've seen them all. Hale and Harvard Glacier. Harvard Glacier.
It is 345 feet high at the center and 1.4 miles wide. Harvard has been advancing for several centuries. Between 1899 and 1986, the glacier advanced over 5,000 feet. Between 1979 and 1986, the glacier advanced approximately 750 feet along its eastern margin, while remaining nearly static across the western half of the terminus. Part of this advance may be attributed to the increased flow from Radcliffe Glacier, which feeds into Harvard Glacier. I'm sure you've wondered what makes the black streaks on the glaciers. They appear almost as highways, but rest assured only nature drives here. They are loose fragments of rock scraped from the valley walls and pushed into lines by the movement of the glacier. When they're dark on the sides, they are lateral moraines.
Glacier Valley. One last look. Here we are in the Port of Seward. That's a sea otter swimming right off the boat. Hi, baby. That's a seagull. Look at the sea otter having a good time. He's going swimming. Then come up, go down. Nobody is seeing this but me. They're in for having breakfast stuck in their faces. They miss all the good stuff. Port looks like, isn't that beautiful? Nestled amongst these mountains. It's like a cloud cover, you can't see a goddamn thing. Unbelievable. Okay, Marsha, we're now in downtown Anchorage. I want you to see what happens when you have the right climate to grow flowers. These are all annuals. But look at the condition of the flowers. Want to see some snapdragons? Man, unbelievable. These petunias, Jim. Look at those snaps. They love the cool weather and lots of rain and lots of clouds. Unbelievable. Get a snap to grow like that. How do you like that, baby? So remember the cornflower? I'll show you what cornflower really looks like when you have the right kind of weather. We couldn't have the earth look like this if God was on our side. And he is, you know. Let's see what lobelia looks like when it's grown in the right weather conditions. How do you like that, babe? Oh, Gary, I haven't mentioned your name either, but you're busy sailing. Snaps, kiddies. That's fuchsia, grown in full sun. Unbelievable, kiddies. Okay, here we are at the Alaska Pipeline. Now, this is exciting.
One of the largest pipeline systems in the world. Most difficult engineering feats of our time. It carries crude oil from Pujo Bay and other reservoirs on the North Slope of Rainier.
Pipeline going into the ground. The pipeline is only above ground where there is permafrost. North of here, that's always permafrost, so it's all above ground. Starting here, it depends, and below Going called Valdez, there is no permafrost, and so it's all below ground. I'll let you read it all for yourself.